Hi guys, welcome to Auditor's Perspective, and this is the second video of Finance Bill 2019. In the previous episode, we have understood about why the share market is crashing, the super rich tax, and how to escape that super rich tax. If you haven't checked that out, just please go to the previous video. And after watching this video, so in this second video we will discuss other groups of this finance bill, the second group of which is the widening of tax base. So under this widening of tax base, they have included many of the TDS provisions. So what I have done is I have clubbed all the TDS provisions of full union budget for one particular video, so that it will help you to have a bird's eye view of all the TDS provisions of this budget at one place. Okay, so except TDS, we will be discussing other amendments for widening of tax base and for promoting of cashless economy for this video, right? And after this, the next video will be on tax incentives, which will help our economy to grow. So that is that video is very interesting actually, where we will see the discussion about IFSCs. What is IFSC? We have seen IFSC's codes of bank, right? So we will discuss whole IFSC, the business of IFSC, and what are the tax incentives and how can that help our economy. So that will be in the next video. In this video there are very interesting amendments in this video, and those will be discussed in here. So to begin with, the first one is actually as it is widening of tax base. What we are doing, we are taxing the income, or which was not actually the income of non-resident, will now be considered as income and will be taxable. So we know this provision actually, and that is 56 section 56 of Income Tax Act, where we have learned that gifts are exempt, right? Gift, that is a sum of money, is exempt, or an immovable property whose stamp duty value exceeds the value of 50,000 is taxable, less than that is exempt. So what we have studied is actually, if any payment of sum or transfer of immovable property is less than 50,000, that is exempt. But if it is more than 50,000, then it will be taxable, not in the hands of mine, but in the hands of recipient. But we have ignored one crucial thing, that is the recipient must be the resident. Okay, so that was the issue, that many of the people of Indian resident people were transferring their immovable property as gifts to the non-resident persons, so which was not taxable in the hands of mine, and also not taxable in the hands of the non-resident as per section 9, because such income is not deemed and accrued to arise in India. Right, so that was not taxable, and this was a major loophole which the people have found out. So this government has actually identified this and said that any sum paid or any immovable property which is situated in India is transferred, okay, as per section 56 10, then the income, that will be treated as income in the hands of such non-resident person and will be liable to be taxed. So this is a good technical move, which any person who is reading 56 section 56 for the first time would not be aware, right? So this is very good amendment. The next one is they have suggested three issues by which they said that if these things, if these three things are being carried out by any person, he must actually required to file his income tax return. What is the rule now? The rule now is the companies and firms are mandatorily required to file return, But individuals, they are required to file return only if the income exceeds the basing exemption limit. But what they have suggested in here is if any person who is depositing more than 1 crore rupees, okay, more than 1 crore rupees in his current account in any particular previous year, then for such previous year he has to file return of income. We know it is very obvious that if any person who is maintaining a current account, he must be doing business, and if he is doing business, he should file his return. Even if that is the amendment, if such business is so low, then he won't be depositing 1 crore rupees, right? If he is depositing 1 crore rupees and not filing his return, then there must be some issues, and he must be escaping taxes. So that person is covered, and the law says that he is required to file his return. The second is, if any person is incurring more than 2 lakh rupees for any foreign travel in a previous year. Okay, I'm highlighting the word 2 lakh rupees and not dollars. If you are going abroad, even say Indonesia or anywhere, if you are investing more than exceeding more than 2 lakh rupees of expenditure for such foreign travel, you are required to file your return. Okay. Third one is, if your electricity consumption is more than 1 lakh rupees per annum. Okay, if you are consuming more than 1 lakh rupees of paying electricity bill of more than 1 lakh rupees, then you will be required to file your income tax return. So these are very meaningful amendment and meaningful thought process of our secretary sir Mr. Pandey sir. Okay, so these are very good moves which can really widen the tax base. And the most talked point of the budget is the interchangeability of Aadhaar and PAN. So for widening the tax base, they have done this. See, they were suggesting from the past 2 years, they were suggesting to us to like link your PAN with Aadhaar, but none or many of us haven't done. Even I actually haven't done for many of my clients, not intentionally, but due to lack of information or lack of the network errors because of the network errors with the UDAI, I couldn't link that. So these were the issues. So what they have done, they have suggested that mandatorily you are now required to link your PAN with Aadhaar. If you don't do that, your PAN will be inoperative. They have suggested in this finance bill. And also, even if you have Aadhaar card, you can file your income tax return, by which they have widened the tax base. So we will move to the next big amendment, which is on cashless, promoting cashless economy. And this is really interesting amendment what I have seen so far. Is it says that if any business person whose turnover or gross receipts or gross sales exceeds 50 lakh rupees in the immediately preceding previous year, then he is required to provide electronic mode of electronic means to make or receive the payment from the customer. Okay, so we have seen in many cases that the people, the businessmen, are not accepting our card payments, right? But now if such tradesman who has more than 50 lakh rupees of turnover in the immediately preceding previous year, he must provide that. But what will happen if we don't? There will be something which will happen, and that is 5000 rupees per day of penalty for not providing such means. So this is very good amendment which will really help increase the cashless economy. And they have also encouraged this by exempting the banks to charge any charges on such transactions. So the bank will not charge such transaction on such transaction which the businessman will provide us. Okay, the means that he will provide us. So in this video we are we have actually discussed these two very important points, right? So about widening of tax base and the cashless economy. And in the next video, because of I actually want to make the video very small and brief, so that people just in while they are traveling or while they are doing nothing, they can just switch to this channel and learn things. In just 10 minutes we have understood now the gifts are taxable in the hands of non-resident, the interchangeability of Aadhaar and PAN, and if the Aadhaar and PAN is not linked, then the PAN will be inoperative. We have also learned the cashless economy, the incentive to the cashless economy. That is, if the businessmen have more than 50 lakh rupees of turnover in immediately preceding previous year, then he is required to provide you the electronic means to make the payment. And if he doesn't, 5000 rupees of penalty, and also bank will not charge any bank charges on such transactions. And also we have learned that you some people are required to file their income tax return if they are investing more, depositing more than 1 crore rupees in the current account, or 2 lakh rupees of foreign travel, or 1 lakh rupees of electricity consumption. So these are the things which we have learned in just 10 minutes. So I want this to happen. I will end up my discussion for this topic in here. The next topic is very interesting, which talk about the tax incentives which will really boost the economy. So where we will discuss I'm actually very much excited for that. So we will discuss the tax incentive part. So thank you guys, thank you. I hope that I have added value to your valuable time. So thank you, and stay updated. Thank you.